Gentle birth. Gentle birth. Ano ba ang gentle birth? Hi everyone, my name is Doctora Cez and thank you so much for watching this video. And in this video, I will be talking about gentle birth. But before I start, please click the like button and also the subscribe button and share this video to other mothers or your friends, sa mga kamag-anak nyo na gustong matuto about gentle birth. Okay, so ano nga ba ang gentle birth? So ang focus ng gentle birth is about the mother's own experience. So ito yung pinagsama-sama natin dito yung experience ng mother physically, emotionally, spiritually, mentally. Tapos nire-respeto natin yung instinct ng nanay, yung kanyang intuition in terms of labor at panganganak. Tsaka yung baby ay isang conscious participant sa kanyang panganganak din. Saan nga ba ginagawa ang gentle birth? Sa Amerika, where home births are allowed, ganun din sa United Kingdom, pwede kasi doon sa mga bansang yun ang gentle birth. So, it can happen in homes, except of course here in the Philippines. Kasi according to DOH, hindi talaga tayo pwedeng mag-home birth. But gentle birth can also happen in birth centers. If nagko-consult kayo sa mga gentle birth OBs o sa mga midwife, so it also happens in hospitals. So ano nga ba ang goal ng gentle birth? Ang goal ng gentle birth is to reclaim the wonder and the joy that are inherent to the beginning of a new life. And dapat ang i-aim dito ng childbirth is a humanized approach, meaning it is child-centered, it is mother-friendly, and family-centered. And above all, it can be gentle while being safe. So ano nga ba yung principles ng gentle birth? So there are 9 ingredients for a gentle birth. Una, number 1, preparation. Pangalawa, privacy. Ibig sabihin, yung environment dapat ay reassuring, tahimik at mahina or may low light. So may freedom to move, continuous labor support, spontaneous ang paglilabor. Tapos yung number 6, 7, 8, and 9 elements are elements of unang yakap. Yung first breath, yung first caress, yung baby nasa breast, at yung bonding and attachment. And so let's discuss first the preparation. So when you say preparation, it is the childbirth education. So very important kasi to na bilang nanay at kasama yung asawa nyo during labor na ma-educate kayo kung ano yung mga pwedeng mangyari habang nagli-labor kayo at during the delivery itself, because not all births end up spontaneously, meaning may mga pagli-labor na pwede talagang mag-end up ng cesarean section para may choices kayo, kasi meron din namang choice for a gentle cesarean section. In addition to the childbirth education classes, which you can enroll with several of our doula partners, or may mga pwede kayong mapanood na YouTube videos on childbirth preparation class. Of course, you need to spend on that kung mag-enroll kayo sa mga face-to-face classes dito sa Philippines, or kung tsatsagain nyo yung mga foreign videos, na mga online videos, that would be free and less expense on your part. So, with preparation, it also involves a healthy attitude. So, dapat yung outlook mo sa pregnancy is positive at madali mong tanggapin din yung mga nangyayari. Like, for example, if you ended up C-section, you should be able to accept that as well. And kailangan open-minded ka and also flexible. The second element is privacy. So when you say privacy, yan yung dim light, minimal interruptions. Tapos kailangan kasi you feel safe. You are in an environment na safe ka para mas lumabas yung natural mong hormone of labor, which is oxytocin. So, ang pangatlong element ng gentle birth is the freedom to move. So, very important yung freedom of movement kasi according to the studies, kapag ka ang mother is lying on her back, may adverse effects sa blood flow, okay? Sa blood flow, papunta kay baby, and also it slows down uterine contractions and progress of labor. And ang maganda kasi sa freedom of movement, when the mother is listening to her body, it actually corrects some of the positions na hindi pala okay sa loob in terms of sa positioning ni baby. So, sometimes I really allow the mother to move kung saan niya gumalaw. Actually, oftentimes, tinatanong ko siya saan ang masakit. So, lilipat siya sa kabilang side. Yun pala, sumisiksik na pala yung head ni baby dun sa side na masakit. Kaya, para mabalance yung positioning ni baby, she needs to move again. So, in my practice, I really allow some exercises sa mother. I do some of the spinning baby moves during labor and birth, even if it's a little bit challenging. So, thank you sa mga mothers na nagko-cooperate with the activities and exercises I let them do. So, during the pushing stage din, we allow or encourage positional changes. Or pwede rin yung upright position during labor and birth. In the pool, during water birth, generally upright kasi yung mother. Kaya maganda yung water birth in terms of positioning. And in the pool, because of the buoyancy of the water, the mother can freely move around, whether paharap, palikod, or naka-rest dun sa rim ng pool. So it's really very helpful. So yun yung benefit ng freedom of movement. Kaya madalas kapag kayo ay nasedate or nabigyan ng gamot, ng pain relievers, limited yung galaw na magagawa natin kasi hindi basta kayo mapapatayo because of baka makatulog kayo na nakatayo or bigla kayong matumba because of the sedative effects. And also when you are on epidural, because reduce yung sensation mo, nang hirap din magpatayo during labor and birth. So most of the activities na kaya lang or pwedeng gawin are on bed. Number 4 element is continuous labor support. So ito yung mga circumstances where you can hire a doula kung meron ka namang budget. So pero ano yung hindi ba kasama sa ginagawa ng mga doula? So, what is not included in the doula support? And so, let's remember, doulas are not medical professionals. And ito yung mga task na hindi dapat gagawin ng mga doula. So, hindi sila na gumagawa ng mga clinical tasks like vaginal exams or fetal heart rate monitoring. They do not give medical advice or even diagnosis. Diagnosis ng mga sakit. Of course, that's the role that we should give to our professional, like your OBs. Okay, definitely your OBs. The midwives are limited din sa mga diagnosis because they only attend to normal pregnancies. So when ma-identify nila yung mga problems, they should be able to refer you to an obstetrician gynecologist. Hindi rin nakakapag-decide yung mga doulas for you, okay? Medical or otherwise. Dapat kayo yung mag-decide for yourself because in the first place, you are the one who are gonna give and sign the consent ng hospital or nung facility where you're gonna give birth. And then, hindi ka dapat nila i-pressure into certain choices just because yun yung gusto nila. Okay, remember that. They do not take over the role of your partner, okay? So, iba din kasi yung support na mabibigay ng mga partners nyo. And they do not catch the baby. Yun ang role ng OB at ng pedia. And they do not change shifts, although some doulas may call in their backup after 12 to 24 hours. So, talagang may commitment ang mga doulas sa inyo when they support. So bakit nga ba importante ang continuous labor support? Because with continuous labor support, na-increase yung oxytocin, nakakagalaw ka, nagiging confident ka, nagle-lessen yung pain, and also, nade-decrease yung anxiety. So, kapag nangyari lahat tong mga to, reduce yung need for epidural. And it also reduces the need for unnecessary interventions like oxytocin. So, nasho-shorten niya yung labor. And because of this, mas higher yung satisfaction mo, mas higher yung chances mo mag-normal delivery, decrease yung CS rates, at mas maganda din yung outcome sa baby. So, yun yung mga benefit kung meron kang continuous labor support. So, pwede namang yung asawa mo, diba, or yung OB mo pagdating niya during labor and delivery. So, those are the benefits. And the other element is spontaneous labor. So, when you say spontaneous labor, wala tayong intervention para pahilabin yung matres nyo. Meaning, we will wait na kusang maghilab yung mga matres nyo. So, why it is spontaneous labor important? Kasi it creates a positive birth memory and immediate bonding with the baby. And it also increases yung opportunity nyo for movement and in being in control. Kasi nga naman, pagka inindus ka, diba, lalagyan ka ng swero. So, sometimes you are confined to the bed. Hindi ka nakakagalaw. At hindi ako, pagka nakaswero ang pasyente, nahihirapan din akong pagalawin siya, patayuin, at ipagawa yung mga activities or exercises na pinapagawa ko during labor. Then, the other element, which ito na yun eh, yung 6, 7, 8, and 9 elements are all components of gentle birth. So, una, yung unang yakap, syempre, i-observe mo yung first breath ni baby. Remember, yung paghinga kasi ni baby is related dun sa oxygenation ng lungs niya after niya lumabas. So, it's very important na hindi mo na ikakat yung cord immediately after birth. Kaya tayo merong delayed cord clamping. So, in my practice, I actually deliver the placenta still connected to the baby. Okay? Kasi nga, kumbaga, it's not actually my preference, but para kasing mas natural yung dating ng panganganak kapag na-deliver mo along with the baby. But there are also exemptions. There are circumstances that I really need to cut the cord. Kasi nga, kailangan i-resuscitate si baby. So, it really depends. But generally, if it's an uncomplicated birth, most of the time, it's a semi-lotus birth for most of my patients. Importante yung delayed cord clamping kasi it adds up an oxygen supply papunta sa lungs ni baby. The more the oxygen supply is, mas maganda at mas malakas yung lungs niya. Okay? And then, the other is first caresses or yung unang yakap. Very important kasi ang unang yakap sa ating mga babies because pag namamassage mo si baby, beneficial siya both for you and your baby in terms of emotional health kasi yung mga natural hormones mas lumalabas sa mommy at sa baby. So yung oxytocin gives them both a sense of bliss and oneness. So, mas nagbabond sila. She's high because of that mother-baby bonding. And then, kaya kahit ano yung fear niya, yung dinaanan niyang pain during labor when she sees her baby, bigla siyang na-energize. If you've noticed that sa mga spontaneous labor. Tapos, of course, very important din yung nakakalatch na si baby after that. So, we all know the breastfeeding contributes to the baby's emotional life. Much of the conventional birthing has caused so much distress nga naman sa mga magong parents as because of the hospital policies. Sometimes, kinukuha si baby, nilalagay sa nursery, diba? Tapos, after 24 hours pa, na nasa nursery si baby, tsaka dadalhin sa room. So, as much as possible, ako kasi, I consider the mother and the baby as one unit. So talagang walang separation ang mommy at baby after birth. Of course, there may be a few minutes that the nursery people need to get your baby, okay, for all the measurements, etc. Pero ako kasi, yung pediatrician partner ko, hindi na niya dinadala sa nursery si baby. So the baby is with the mother at the recovery room, or if directly roomed in, kasabay na ni mommy si baby. So that's my practice. Kasi very important yung bonding and attachment nila. And so remember that the principles of gentle birth is that there is low intervention, so hindi masyadong napapakialaman yung labor, walang induction, unless necessary, say for example, pag pumutok yung bag of water. And the other principle of gentle birth is it is humanized, meaning it is baby-centered, it is mother-centered, it is family-centered. So, paano, Doc, kapag nag-end up ako na cesarean section, can we do the gentle birth approach? Of course we can, okay? So sa ibang bansa kasi, they have that clear drapes. So mga instead na yung mga cloth na ginagamit namin pangharang, clear drapes yung ginagamit nila. So yung mother gising, tapos nakikita niya yung time na nilalabas si baby out of her uterus and out of her abdomen. So nakikita niya yun. So yun yung gentle birth approach. And then, na-observe pa rin yung delayed cord clamping. So after birthing the baby, dinediretso na siya sa chest niya para ma-observe yung unang yakap. Yun yung gentle birth. For me personally, I am able to practice gentle cesarean section. The modified way nga lang kasi we don't have the clear drapes sa hospital. So what I do is I show the mom on top of her para makita niya agad yung baby paglabas. And then, pinapadaan ko si baby under the drapes so the baby can crawl into her chest and into her breast. And then, latch on. And of course, the father is also in the operating room with her. Okay, so that's how I modify the gentle cesarean C-sections I do. And the benefit of a gentle birth is really a positive birth experience for you. So, knowing all this, I'm teaching you the gentle birth way para alam nyo kung ano yung mga isusulot nyo sa mga birth plans nyo. I hope that in my next video, I would be able to teach you how to write your birth plans. And I hope you learned a lot from here. And kung may tanong kayo, just type in the message box below. And I hope I would be able to answer them as promptly as I can. And I hope na madami kayong natutunan. And thank you so much for watching this video. Bye!